I am here with what we like to refer to as a foreigner. And I'm really excited to be here too as well. Now you are Buck.
Okay, Buck 20.
Yeah. I'm sure you probably get that a lot, 5720. Are there any distinctions that people should look out for?
My haircut's slightly different, but other than that, you won't be able to tell, but we have got our names on the back of our t-shirts now, so you'll be able to see it.
Okay, right there.
It's only small, but then if you actually look closely, you can see it, so.
Okay. What was the plane ride? Was it hectic? Was it crazy?
It wasn't too bad. It took us about 12 hours in total, because we had a seven or eight hour flight to actually get to here from UK, so London to DC, then DC to Dallas. But then we had to stay at the airport overnight because our flight was so early in the morning. So we traveled for about 24 hours, roughly.
Jeez, that sounds like a freaking anthill, just going through all the tunnels. You know, what number event is this for you? And how many have you been to? And then how do you feel?
I've kind of lost count. I think it's about my 10th or 11th event I've been to. Like, I started coming in 2000.
Yeah,
and
gotcha.
My first proper event was Anaheim 2009, and we've come since then, so I've been to a few events.
Okay.
But it's the second or third time I've been to Dallas, and it's a really good venue.
Yeah, okay. Now, you guys have been playing for a while. When did you guys start playing Halo, and was it like you and your brother? How did you guys get into it?
Well, we started playing Halo 1 like with our dad back when it first came out.
Yeah.
So we started playing with him, and then he kind of played with us until we got too good, and he kind of got pissed off that we were so good. So he kind of gave up and told us to go online and play that. But yeah, we started playing Halo 3 when it first came out. I went into a tournament in London, won £600, coming second. So from then on, I thought, hang on a minute, I can actually make money from playing video games. So I started playing it more professionally.
Yeah. I know when it comes to making a living gaming, and obviously your parents' perspective on that, was that something that your parents were really accepting from you or initially on, or was it something that, like, okay, here's the paycheck, now it's real?
They didn't really mind that much. My mum found it quite good, because instead of being out and about hanging around the streets, I was inside playing Xbox, and actually, like, I was talking to people that were a lot older than myself, so I think I've become more mature because of that. So when I was only 13, 14, I was playing with people that were 18 or 19, so it did help in terms of my maturity. And also, it's just a good thing to do, and I get to travel around the world because of it. I've been to, like, all around Europe, America, and I hope to go to Australia and stuff later in the year, hopefully.
Out of all the events you've been to, were leagues, competitions, where's your top league? Where's your top event? Where's your top competition? Where would you want to go to if you have the chance to go anywhere in the world to go compete in your favorite game?
I love MLG events. Every American event I've been to is huge compared to England. Like, in the EG, we have EGL events out there. Like, they're quite good, but there's only 20 or 30 teams that go, like, max 50. But, like, this weekend we've got 250 teams.
Yeah.
So compared to most events, this is huge. And I just love how much competition there is here.
Now we got Halo 4. Halo is back. I know I've been talking to a bunch of people in the crowd. They seem really excited. What is your expectations? What's your hype? How are you feeling about the game?
I think this game's really good. I've played it a few times at promotional events already, so I've had the chance to play it at some pre-launch events in London and around the UK. So it's a really good game, and I've played it quite a lot. So I've played some fans or the community at events, like me and my brother play against a pro kind of thing. And it's a really good game. It's kind of a combination of Halo 3 and Halo Reach, but I think it's a really good mix, and I can't wait to play it.
Okay. And real quick, your favorite weapon, favorite gun. I know I've been hearing some people talk about they're loving that the BR is back. How do you feel about some of the weapons, or maybe some of the changes?
I think that it's good that the DMR and BR are both in it, because it gives you kind of like, if you want to use the BR, you can, so it's a bit of a different option that you don't have to stick to using DMR all the time. So it's good that MLG have kind of implemented that as well. But I think the BR is better close range, just about, but the DMR is a lot better long range. And also, my favorite weapon would be the incineration cannon. I don't think it's actually in MLG, but it's amazing. Like, you just fire it at someone and it kills anything in that vicinity. So it's really good.
Okay, how has your support been? I know, of course, you guys coming over from the UK. How does the fan support? How does the spectator support? I mean, do you guys get a lot of support coming here from the MLG events?
Yeah, we do always get quite a lot of support, because we've been here for like 2 or 3 years now. So people know us, they know our names, they know our faces. So when we come over there, there's always people like, hey, they're the Bucks, they're the Europeans. So we get quite a lot of fans. There's always going to be a few people that kind of don't want us to do well, because it's just because they think that Americans are better than Europeans kind of thing. That's always going to be a bit of a kind of hassle, but yeah, most of our fans are really, really, really helpful with us. And they said, like, I think in Dallas last, when we came to, we didn't actually have a hotel, so someone actually hooked us up with a hotel, a sponsor, like, on the day. So it's really good to have fans like that.
Back in the day when you were working with Power Gaming, I know you had a little bit of a different roster lineup. What is the change that's been happening so far since then to your new roster now? Was it just maybe some personal problems on the team, or maybe people just kind of have some financial issues, or I mean, what happened to obviously get to the roster that you're at now?
Well, basically, I think during Power Gaming we had a really good roster for quite a long time, but after a while, either like teammates got too busy with like the actual life and can't kind of dedicate their life to playing games anymore, or they're just like sometimes you just need a change, like, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes you need to have a change in the team, so because you get like mixed up a bit, get some fresh players in there. But we have two more players in our team called Frankie and JC with us. They're quite new players, but they're quite experienced. They've been playing playing Halo 3 for like quite a long time, and they're really good players. Like, they're in the top four in Europe. So we picked them up after leaving Riot and Fusion, the other two European players that were considered pro as well. So they're really good players. They're really dedicated to the game. They play more than us, and they just want to really win. So it's good to have them on the team.
Do you have any rivals here? I mean, are there anyone that like you guys like maybe know, or you've had a chance to spend time with at MLG events that you kind of have somewhat of a beef or maybe a trash talk session kind of going on?
I'm not really sure. We know quite a lot of the American pros, so it's good to play them in any kind of game. But also Reaction, because he's from Europe. Like he was from Europe like initially, but he's moved over to America. So he's on an American team. So it's still kind of us fighting against him for who can be the best European.
Okay.
So we want to try and outplace him if we can, and also I want to try and beat our best placements, which was 10th. So I need to try and get 9th or above.
Okay.
So top 8 would be amazing.
Reaction, they're coming for you. Don't worry about it, because they want that blood. More like e-blood, so it's going to be more like a splatter shot, so to speak. Any final shout-outs to sponsors, fans, family, anyone you want to go ahead and say to?
Just a shout-out to Western Wolves. They fund us so well and support us so well. Without them, we wouldn't be able to come out to America. So it's just really great that we got support from both Western Wolves and Mad Cats, and also Triton. So these guys help us get out, and they pay so much money towards our flights and stuff, so it's great. And also to all of our fans watching this weekend, and also thank you for voting for us for the main stage tonight. So I think we get to play Immunity tonight about 10 o'clock on the main stage. That's really great. We've got like 50% of the votes out to everybody. So
really? Okay, awesome. Secretly, I did vote for them. I just want to point that out. I did want to see some foreign play. So listen, thank you so much, Buck. I appreciate it for the interview.